Commercial fishing is the activity of catching fish and other seafood for commercial profit, mostly from wild fisheries. It provides a large quantity of food to many countries around the world. The fishing industry has had to adapt through the years in order to keep earning a profit. Commercial fishermen harvest a wide variety of animals, including tuna, cod, salmon, shrimp, lobster, squid, oysters, crabs, and more. Commercial fishing uses many different methods to catch a large variety of species. This includes large nets, pole and lines, traps or pots, and trolling with single lines, as well as trawling. Fishing industries are also owned by small families and not only major corporations. A study taken on some small family-owned commercial fishing companies showed that they adapted to continue to earn a living, not necessarily to earn a large profit. It is the adaptability of fishermen and their methods that resulted in concern for fishery managers and researchers, such as the sustainability of marine ecosystems, which could be in danger of being ruined. The FAO estimates that more than 70% of the world's fish species are depleted or fully exploited. It is estimated that at the current rate, 90% of the fish and shellfish species that are hauled from the ocean to feed people worldwide will be gone by 2048. Commercial fishing has a major impact on the ecology of oceans. There is also a reduction in fish stocks globally to support the world's growing population and their demand for seafood. Commercial fishing industries that utilize nets may inadvertently capture and kill other marine animals, including turtles, dolphins, and whales, which are known as bycatching. Active gears that are also utilized by commercial fishing industries impact the physical nature of seabeds and communities of species that either grow, live in, or on it. Commercial fishing will be affected economically through changes in fish recruitment, mortality, migratory patterns, and growth rates. Climate change impacts many industries, and this includes commercial fishing industry as well. The biggest effect that climate change has on seas is increasing its temperature. For example, in the North Sea, temperature has risen by 1 degree Celsius over the last 30 years. It takes a change of about 0.2 degrees Celsius to cause stress in many commercial fish species. The most recent scientific report states that the North Sea surface temperature is increasing at a rate of 0.6 to 0.8 degrees Celsius per decade. By the period of 2070 to 2090, the average increase in sea surface temperature will have reached 2.45 degrees Celsius in the North Sea, using the 1960 to 1919 data as a baseline. There are distinct changes in species in the seas. The most recent common example of this is how sand eels in shallow shores and mud flats are being replaced by hard-bodied pipefish. In order to maintain their metabolic and phonologic patterns, fish are not only moving north but also to deeper waters to maintain most suitable temperatures. This will inevitably put pressure on current fishing practices.
There are also some obvious benefits of commercial fishing. The main advantage of the commercial fishing industry is that it provides a steady supply of seafood that is demanded worldwide. This is important for inland communities that want to benefit from eating fresh seafood but cannot go out to obtain it themselves. For example, people in Oklahoma would not have access to the Maine lobster, Pacific rockfish, or Alaskan crab if it was not for commercial fishing industries. Commercial fishing industries also provide people with more options for omega fatty acid intake. Omega fatty acids are found in fish such as salmon, tuna, and more. It is also found in other seafood, including algae and krill. In countries of the Pacific, citizens derive between 25 to 69% of animal protein from fish. According to the University of Maryland Medical Center, omega fatty acid is essential to the human body. Commercial fishing industries makes it possible by supplying fish to the people that do not have access to it naturally, thus making people more healthy. Commercial fishing is a major economic activity that employs more than 200 million people around the globe, generating more than $80 billion a year. Commercial fishing is also a lot safer than aquaculture. For example, farmed fish have an increased chance of getting parasites such as sea lice as opposed to fish in its natural environment.
Even though the world's fisheries are under more pressure than before, there is still hope. Fisheries can be restored through the adoption of sustainable fishing practices. Fishers can be encouraged and rewarded in their effort to sustainably manage marine resources. For example, in the Philippines, there was an establishment of marine reserves to help manage overexploited fisheries through partnerships between local communities and scientists.
Another solution is to use the power of marketing to encourage sustainable fishing practices and setting strict standards for commercial fishing. The establishment of no fishing zones in the reserves has increased catches in the adjacent fishing grounds. The Marine Stewardship Council, together with the World Wildlife Federation and Unilever, one of the largest makers of fish products, has developed a certification process that includes a label informing consumers that the fish products came from fisheries certified as sustainable.